Take a deep breath in. Exhaling, step or lightly jump your feet 3.5 feet apart, facing to the right side of your mat, arms extended out to your sides. Moving from inside your right hip, turn your right leg out 90 degrees, left foot slightly in. Gaze out over your left fingertips, or if you have neck strain, gaze over your right fingertips. Press more firmly into your feet, firming your legs, lifting your right kneecap, and shift your hips to the left as much as you can. As you inhale, extend out as far as you can through your right arm and side. Exhaling, keep that extension and draw your right hand down to wherever it naturally lands on your shin, ankle, or foot. If you have neck issues, let your head release toward the floor, relax your neck completely, and look down. Otherwise, your gaze already up to your left thumb. If your hand landed naturally on your foot or ankle, then consider clasping and pulling up on your big toe, Ashtanga style. Breathe. Pressing firmly down into your right foot, without moving it at all, feel as though you want to spiral your right foot clockwise into the floor, knee pointing straight forward, feeling how that subtle action helps you to draw your right sitting bone more back and under towards your left heel. Energetically spiral your left foot counterclockwise into the floor without actually moving it, and feel how this action helps you to roll your left thigh and hip more open as you spread across your groins. Lengthen more through your spine, drawing your right ribs along your left ribs into your body, heart center spreading and revolving up as you draw both shoulders down your back. Press more into your feet, and on your next inhale, reach up more through your left arm to come all the way up to standing. Turn your left leg out, right foot slightly in. Gaze over your right hand. As you press into your feet, hips shift to the right as you extend out long through your left side and arm, exhaling left hand to your shin or ankle, or clasping your left big toe and lifting up. Keep rooting into your feet. Same energetic actions in your feet. Left foot spiraling counterclockwise, right foot clockwise without actually moving your feet. Lengthen through your spine, spread across your chest, your shoulders, twisting open, breathing deeply. Keep your gaze steady, your breath steady, rooting into your feet, inner left arch lifting as you strengthen your legs even more, extending energy into the earth, out through your spine and out through the crown of your head. Take one more inhale here. Stay to complete all of your exhale. Inhaling, slowly bring yourself up to standing, feet to parallel, hands to your hips. Inhaling, extend tall through your spine. Exhaling, fold forward and down, placing your palms on the floor, fingertips in line with the tips of your toes. Inhaling, come onto your fingertips, lengthening forward. Exhaling, keep that length in the front of your spine as you fold down, Prasarita, Padottanasana A. Press firmly in to all four corners of your feet, inner arches lifting, legs firm, sitting bones lifting and spreading, palms pressing as you keep lengthening from your belly to your sternum. Either stay here working with this pose, staying with your breath, or if you're comfortable with tripod headstand, slide your wrist back beneath your elbows, elbows shoulder distance apart, crown of your head pressing into the floor. Inhaling, extend your legs slowly and steadily out and up, pressing your ankles together as you press out through the balls of your feet, toes spreading, palms pressing, shoulders drawing up and into your back. Stay here for a couple of more breaths. Extending up through the core of your legs, one more inhale. Exhaling, slowly release your feet back to the floor, light as feathers. Inhaling, extend your spine forward. Exhaling, draw your hands to your hips. Stay here with a flat back. Inhale, come all the way back up to standing. Exhale. Separate your feet about 6 inches further apart, preparing for Virabhadrasana 2, Warrior 2 pose. Turn your right foot out 90 degrees, left foot slightly in. Extend your arms out to your sides and gaze out over your right fingertips. Pressing into your feet, take a deep breath in. Exhaling, slowly bend your right knee directly over your ankle, knee pressing toward the little toe side of your foot. Over time, your thigh level with the floor. Just for a moment, turn your palms up. Draw your shoulders more down your back. Extend your arms away from each other, and then simply turn your palms back over, breathing, gazing out over your right fingertips. Keep pressing into your feet. Same energetic actions as in triangle pose. Right foot spiraling energetically clockwise, left foot counterclockwise as you ground the outer edge of your left foot, lifting your inner left arch, left thigh pressing back. Keep extending up through your core, out through your arms. Press more into your feet, and on your next inhale, slowly straighten your right leg. Shift your left leg out, right foot in. Exhaling, bend your left knee until it's just over your ankle, Virabhadrasana 2. press your feet. Legs strong, breath alive. Mula Bandha, lifting from your perineum, drawing energy more up through your core, heart center, lifting and spreading, a feeling of stretching from your collarbones out through your index fingers and beyond, from your shoulder blades through your pinkies and beyond, breathing. Face relaxed, breath steady, gaze steadily out over your fingertips, outer corners of your lips drawing lightly towards your ears. Take one more deep breath in here. Stay to complete all of your exhale, lowering a little bit more. Then inhaling, press your feet and slowly straighten your left leg. Again, right leg out, left foot slightly in. Deep inhale. Exhaling, bend your right knee over your ankle, Virabhadrasana 2. Inhaling, reach your left hand down your back leg as you reach your right arm over and back into a reverse warrior. Exhaling, keep that length in your right side as you extend forward, reaching your right elbow to your right knee or right palm to the floor to the outside of your ankle, Parsva Konasana, extended right angle. See that your right knee is directly over your ankle. Extend up through your left arm, spiraling from your left shoulder, turn the little finger side of your right hand toward your face and reach your left arm forward, overhead, feeling the line of energy as you stretch from your left heel out through your left fingertips. Keep pressing into your feet. Rooting the outer edge of your left foot, lifting your inner left arch, rolling your left thigh, belly, and heart open towards the sky. If you'd like, draw your right arm to the inside of your right leg. Reach it under and clasp your left hand or wrist behind your back. If in doing this you find yourself straining or collapsing more in your chest, then back off. Whichever variation you're in, on your next exhale, look down and reach your left arm straight up. Inhaling, keep your right knee directly over your ankle and slowly come back up to Virabhadrasana 2. Stay to exhale. Inhaling, slowly straighten your right leg all the way up to standing. Shift your left leg out, right foot in. Arms extended out. Exhaling, bend your left knee over your ankle. Inhaling, slide your right hand down your back leg, stretching back. Exhaling, take that length in your left side with you as you extend forward into Parsva Konasana, breathing. Work from your roots, feet pressing, reach your right arm over. Leg strong, energy drawing up your inner right thigh as you press your right thigh back, left knee to the little toe side of your foot. Stretching long from your right heel through your core to your fingertips. Take the variation that works for you, wrapping if you'd like, staying with your breath, smooth, deep, full, rhythmic inhales and exhales. It doesn't matter how far you go, but rather how you go, moving consciously, honoring the inner wisdom of your body as you listen and feel inside for guidance in your practice. Take a couple of more breaths here, heart center extending forward and rolling open towards the sky. On your next exhale, look down and reach your right arm straight up. Then inhaling, lift your torso straight up, back into Virabhadrasana 2, left knee still over your ankle. Complete your exhale here. Inhaling, slowly press all the way up to standing. Turn your feet to parallel. Draw your hands to your hips. Bring your feet a little closer together, about 3 feet apart. Inhaling, extend your arms out to your sides. Exhaling, spread across your chest and back. Exhaling, interlace your fingers behind your back, palms pressing together, preparing for Prasarita Palottanasana C. Press into your feet, firming your legs. Inhaling, lift taller through your core. Exhaling, fold forward and down, reaching your arms over and down towards the floor. If your shoulders are too tight to keep your hands clasped and extended away from your back, then clasp a strap with both hands, hands as wide apart as you need, and reach your arms over and down, keeping hold of the strap. Press more into your feet, energy drawing up your inner ankles and thighs, pressing from your outer hips to your outer ankles. Root down, stay with your breath. Stretch the front of your spine. On your next inhale, leading with your heart, come all the way back up to standing with a flat back. Exhaling, hands to your hips. Inhaling, extend your arms out to your sides. Exhaling, draw your hands behind your back, either clasping your wrists, elbows, or if you can, reverse namaste, palms together, fingers pointing up your back and as high up your back as you can reach them. Turn your right foot out 90 degrees, your left foot in until it's almost parallel to your right foot. Press into your feet, strong legs, inhaling, lift up through your core. Exhaling, fold forward and down, heart center extending straight out over your shin, sternum towards your toes, feet rooting, legs strong, Parsva Tanasana. Root more into your left heel, drawing your inner left thigh back as you press into all four corners of your right foot and lift your right kneecap, engaging your quadriceps muscles. steadiness of effort, of breath, steadiness in your gaze, pressing more into your feet. Inhaling, lead with your heart to come all the way back up to standing, shifting your left leg out, right foot in, almost parallel to your left. Deep breath in, extending up through your spine. Exhaling, keep your legs strong as you extend forward and down. If you have reverse namaste, keep pressing your palms, knuckles, and fingers together, elbows lifting, lengthening from your belly to your sternum as you keep rooting firmly into your feet. Inhaling, come all the way up to standing, feet to parallel, hands to your hips. Again, turn your right foot out 90 degrees, left foot in almost parallel. With your right hand on your hip, inhaling, reach up through your left arm as much as you can. Exhaling, extend forward and down, drawing your left hand to either the inside or, if you're more flexible, the outside of your right foot, Parvrita Trikonasana, twisting triangle. Keep your right knee pointing straight forward, kneecap lifting by firming your thigh, feet rooting firmly down. Keeping your hips level, reach your right arm straight up, lengthening more through the front of your spine as you spiral your heart center open more towards the sky, breath full and alive. Deep, conscious Ujjayi Pranayama. Keep drawing your right hip back, spiraling your inner left thigh back by pressing more into your left heel and lifting your inner left arch. On your next exhale, look down. Inhaling, press into your feet and slowly windmill up and around to the other side, left foot out, right foot in, almost parallel. Left hand to your hip, inhaling, extend up to your right side. Exhaling, extend forward and down, right palm to the inside, or if you're more flexible, the outside of your left foot, breathing. Press into your feet, lengthen your spine, reaching up to your left arm, heart center opening. Stay with your breath, cultivating steadiness and ease amidst the challenges this pose brings to your balance, your breath, your legs, back and hips. Take one more breath in here. Exhaling, look down. Inhaling, slowly windmill up to center. Exhaling, step or jump back to the front of your mat, Samasthiti, palms together at your heart. Smooth, steady breath, rooted, extending, relaxed and balanced, strong and at ease. Close your eyes and draw your forehead to your fingertips. Remember your intention in this practice. Take it more deeply into your heart.